Hello everyone, this is Leelarani, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Kamraj College of Engineering and Technology. In this video, I am going to discuss about JSON serialization in Flutter. First of all, what is JSON? JSON, which stands for JavaScript Object Notation, it is a lightweight data interchange format, right? Most often it used when the data is sent from server to a web page. Next one is serialization. As we all know, serialization is the process of converting object, any object, into a format that can be stored or transmitted. Now, the question is why JSON serialization in Flutter? First thing, what is a Flutter? So, Flutter is a user interface software development kit. In Flutter, we are using a Dart language to develop a mobile application. Now, JSON serialization in Flutter, it is the process of converting your Dart object into a JSON format. So, that is for storage or transmission. So, why JSON serialization in Flutter? It is very hard to think of a mobile application that doesn't need communication with web server, right? So, most of the mobile applications are network connected mobile applications. For that network connected mobile application, we need a JSON format for a transmissions of a data. So, it mainly enables a communication between the application and external data sources. So, now we are going to see the structure of a JSON. So, this is what a JSON structure. So, every JSON object which is surrounded by a curly braces, it consists of 0, 1 or more key value pairs. Keys are strings, values are dynamic. That is, it may be numbers, arrays, object, booleans and so on. Here, JSON format, this is a JSON object which is surrounded by a curly braces, and each and every key value pair which is separated by comma. Here, name, age, is student, courses or keys. So, these are all strings, and John, 30, true, math and science, these are all values. It is dynamic one. So, it can be a string, numbers or on arrays as maybe. Next, actually there are two common approaches in JSON serialization. One is manual serialization, another one is automatic serialization. So, both what we have to do is we have to convert our Dart object into a JSON format, right. So, in manual serialization, we ourselves, that is developers, have to write their own code to convert a object into a convert from object into a data format, right, that is manually. Next, automatic serialization, we no need to write a code, it automatically converts a serialization code based on the annotation that is given in our Dart classes, right. So, in manual serialization, we ourselves, that is developers, have to write their own code to convert a object into a data format, that is Dart object into a JSON format. In automatic serialization, we no need to write, it automatically generates a serialization code for converting a Dart object into a JSON format. So, based on the annotation that is given in the Dart classes. So, let me explain a manual JSON serialization. So, in manual serialization, as we know, it automatically convert to a Dart object into a JSON format, right. So, in this process, it mainly requires the developers to write their methods, their own serialization method to their Dart classes, within their Dart classes, to handle the conversion between object properties and JSON data. So, it compared to automatic serialization, it takes some time to convert to a Dart object into a JSON format. So, this is what a sample code snippet of manual serialization is. First of all, typically we have to import Dart convert library. Why we import this means we have to using a function called JSON encode off. For that we have to import, and followed by we have to create a class which is named as person with two attributes, here name and age. So these are all two attributes. In this person class, it has a two JSON of method. In this method, which using this method, we have to convert our object into a map, right? So map, which consists of keys and values. Clear? And next, inside the main function, we all know that each and every class we have to create an object. Here class name is person. So for the person name, we have to create an object person. So with allies and 30. Now we using this JSON encode of function, that is from import dot convert library, which is used to convert our object into JSON manually. So this is what a manual serialization concepts. Here finally we print this JSON string that representing person serializable objects, serializable object. So it is manually printed. Next one is, so this is what the advantages. So advantages is we no need to add any dependencies in manual conversions, and customized error handling and transparency. Disadvantages are it is very difficult to maintain manually, and code duplications sometimes it may occur, no built-in validations, and performance overhead. Performance, it is very that is compared to an automatic, it is somewhat complex to generate our own code, right? So performance overhead and limited error handling, right? Next one is automatic, mainly manual serialization is most probably used for a smaller projects. For larger projects, we go for automatic JSON serialization. So it mainly used for a larger projects. In that, what we have to do is, first we have to add two dependencies, right? One is JSON serializable, another one is built runner, right? So as already said, in manual serialization, serialization code is automatically converted, automatically generated based on the annotations given in the dot classes, right? So what is that annotation means? It is JSON serializable. This is what annotation. It is a most popular library. In this, using JSON serializable annotation, it automatically convert a serializable code, right? So and then it mainly, why we use this? It mainly simplifies the serialization process and reduces the boilerplate code. Right, this is what a code snippet. In automatic, we must add two dependencies. One is JSON serializable, another one is built runner. Where we have to include it? We have to include in your bubspec.yaml file. This is means publish a package specifications dot int markup language. In this file, we have to add two dependencies. One is serializable, another one is built runner. In this built runner, it automatically, using this built runner, the file is automatically generated, right? This is what the code snippet. As I said, using annotations given in the Dart classes, we have to automatically convert the serialization code. The annotation is at JSON serializable of here. So first we have to import that annotation package. This person dot file is automatically created. If suppose it is not created, means you have to include the you have to run the built runner code. This is what a built runner code. You have, once you run this code, and the file is automatically this file is automatically generated, that is serializable code. As same the process, what we have to do is we have to define the class, and here named as a person, and with two attributes, names and age. And here the person class, which has a two JSON of method, which is used to convert our objects into a map, and followed by we have to typically we have to import a dot convert library. Why we add this is we have to use this function, JSON encode of function. This function is automatically converted our objects into a key values pair, that is JSON format. So this is what the output. So advantages here is it mainly simplifies your serialization process, and boilerplate code, reduces the boilerplate code, less error prone, mainly less error prone, improved productivity, type safety, integrations with build process. Disadvantages, dependency management and less control. Thank you.